There is no denying that EVs are here to stay. With the rising number of electric vehicles sold each year, expanding of charging network, and advances in build technology and construction, EVs are slowly taking over. However, even though the current electric vehicles are thoroughly modern contraptions, the basic concept is old as the automobile itself. In fact, back in the dawn of the automotive industry, electricity battled with gasoline as the fuel of choice. As we know, oil took over simply because it was more practical to raise the range and power simply by enlarging the displacement and size of the fuel tank. But electricity never entirely went away, and ambitious car designers and car companies always tried to reintroduce the concept to a broader audience. Over the years, there were numerous electric cars introduced, but most remained only a prototype. However, more than a few semi-successful models preceded modern vehicles and show that the EV concept has a future. Today, we will introduce you to 10 forgotten electric vehicles from well-known brands that kept the flame alive and led the way for modern EV brands and models. One of the first post-war electric cars that were commercially available was the Henney Kilowatt, introduced in 1959. This little car was a joint venture by several companies, and it was based on the tiny Renault Dauphine, a little French car that was officially sold in the US. The Renault supplied the bodies without the engine, and then the cars were fitted with small 7-horsepower electric motors, battery pack, and the rest. The first examples had the range of only 40 miles, while later models could travel up to 65 on a single charge. Production only lasted 2 years, and 100 cars were made, of which 47 were actually sold to the public. The 70s were times of oil crisis and the first big pushes towards cleaner air and clean energy. So it's no surprise that AMC presented the Pacer EVA, which was its first and only electric car. The AMC company was always a free-thinking, independent manufacturer. When Electric Vehicle Association approached them in the 70s, AMC supplied the chassis and EVA did the rest. The Pacer EVA had 2 battery packs and a single electric motor, a range of 53 miles, but an enormous asking price of almost $14,000 in 1978. Even so, about 100 cars were actually built and sold, and Pacer EVA was the first electric car to feature regenerative braking. Probably the first proper EV ever marketed was the legendary GM EV1, which debuted in 1996. Even though it was rudimentary by today's standards, the EV1 was cutting edge in the late 90s and featured a powerful 137 horsepower engine and a range of up to 105 miles on later models. It was designed and produced as an experimental vehicle, but offered to the general public through controversial lease deals. Over 1,100 cars were eventually built during its short production span, which is a large number compared to previous similar attempts. The EV1 project was very costly for GM, but it showed the potential, and critics today claim that it was cancelled before it could make a bigger impact on the car buying community. The first electric cars had a small range and high price tags, but from 1993 to 1995, Chrysler TEVan is probably the craziest example. This was a special model sold only to utility companies for a cool $120,000, which was extremely expensive in the early 90s. It was powered by a single electric motor, had 2-speed transmission, and a nickel iron or nickel cadmium battery pack. The result was a range of 80 miles and a top speed of about 70 miles per hour, which is pretty decent. Since it was based on a classic Chrysler Voyager minivan, the TEVan was very practical, had ample space in the interior, and could carry 5 adults along with their luggage. The production ceased in 1995 after 56 cars were made. If you think that Mustang Mach-E is Ford's first electric vehicle, you're sadly mistaken. This honour goes to the 1998 to 2002 Ford Ranger EV, a mid-sized truck with a single Siemens Type 1 electric motor and battery pack mounted underneath the vehicle. Ford wanted to explore the possibilities of entering large-scale EV production and decided to use the Ranger platform for this research. With 90 horsepower coming from a single motor and powering rear wheels, Ranger EV had a 22 kilowatt-hour battery pack, which was enough for 115 miles of range. The reality was that most examples had a range of about 60 miles, and the whole project was plagued with numerous problems. However, the Ranger EV had decent driving dynamics and moderate performance, and showed that the electric truck concept makes sense as we know it today. One of the most exciting models amongst the forgotten electric cars is the tiny but fun Honda EV Plus. Introduced in 1997, it was a compact, three-door model powered by a single electric motor and a 28.7 kilowatt-hour battery pack. Even though it was a small car, EV Plus was well-equipped and had an enormous price tag of almost $54,000 in 1997. As with all early EVs, you couldn't buy it regularly, but only lease it through a special program for $455 per month. Even though the range was limited, somewhere around 80 to 105 miles, EV Plus gained praise from journalists for its acceleration, and this was one of the first electric models that showed just how quick the battery-powered vehicles could be. This tiny Honda could reach 60 miles per hour in about 6 seconds, which was pretty fast for the late 90s. Due to high price and specific technology, only about 300 were built, and very few remain today. The Rav4 EV, produced from 1997 to 2003, is one of the most successful early electric vehicles since it was built in somewhat large numbers and it was also offered to the general public. The standard production ICE-powered Rav4 was used as a basis, and two electric motors were added along with a battery pack with 27.4 kilowatt-hour capacity. The result was an electric SUV with a range of 95 miles and a top speed of 85 miles per hour. It wasn't very fast, getting to 60 miles an hour in around 18 seconds, but its purpose was to test new technologies, not to win stoplight races. Interestingly, the Rav4 EV proved very reliable, and many test examples covered well over 150,000 miles on the original battery. At the end of the production, over 1,140 were sold or leased, which could be considered a success. At the same time General Motors started promoting the legendary EV1 to the public, Chevrolet decided to try its luck with a practical yet not very successful S10 electric truck. It was based on the regular S10 pickup, but with a 114 horsepower strong electric motor and 29 kilowatt hour battery pack in later versions. The range was modest, and the best test result was 95 miles. Although most examples achieved considerably less than that. The S10 was in production for just two model years, 1997 and 1998, with a slight difference in technology, battery capacity, and design between both years. In the end, Chevrolet produced just under 500 examples, and most have been sold to utility companies. Some were even used long after the production had stopped. Nissan made its name with Leaf, a globally successful electric vehicle, but it wasn't the company's first. The first battery-powered Nissan was the Altra, produced from 1997 to 2001. It was known as Nissan R-Nessa on the domestic market and Altra for export markets. The importance of this car is the fact that it was the first vehicle to use lithium-ion batteries, which are now the standard of the industry. Using advanced technology meant that Altra had more extended range than other cars on the market, with 130 to 140 miles between charging. Also, it was a very well-optioned vehicle, and its crossover body style offered a lot of usable space. The production stopped in 2001 after about 200 cars were made. It's funny how people totally forget the Focus Electric, even though it was discontinued in only 2018, which wasn't that long ago. The rush of more modern and more powerful electric cars made those older ones obsolete and forgotten in no time. However, this Ford's attempt can be considered well executed and successful, and helped trace the path of today's vehicles. Focus Electric was introduced in late 2011 and offered in the US and Europe. The only difference between standard and a battery-powered Focus was the front grille. Under the hood was a 143 horsepower strong electric motor, powered by a 23 or 33.5 kilowatt-hour battery, which guaranteed up to 115 miles of range. The US production of Focus Electric was around 9,000 examples, with several thousand more sold worldwide. Thank you for watching our video, and we hope you enjoyed our selection of the most interesting forgotten electric vehicles. What are your favorites, and do you plan to purchase any similar models? Please Share your thoughts in the comment section below and like, share and subscribe to our channel for the best and most comprehensive videos regarding the world of battery powered cars.